Thank you very much. Thank you. So beautiful out here. And thank you for joining us as we announce a massive and groundbreaking expansion in our testing capability of the for the China virus. And as you know, it's already setting records, records like nobody's ever seen before. Last week, we crossed a historic milestone when the United States conducted our 100 millionth test, far more than any other country, and not even close, actually. Second seems to be India, with 1.5 billion people, and the numbers would be probably at least 50 million more tests by us. We've conducted more tests than the entire European Union and more than all of Latin America combined. We're thrilled to be joined by Vice President Mike Pence, Secretary of Health and Human Services, Alex Azar, Secretary of Education, Betsy DeVos, hi Betsy, Administrator for the Centers for Medicine and Medicaid Services, Seema Verma, and Admiral Jouar, who's done such an incredible job. Thank you, Admiral. We're also joined by Mississippi Governor Tate Reeves, had a tremendous victory, we're so proud of you, and as well by Abbott CEO Robert Ford. Robert, thank you very much. Great job. Today, I'm pleased to report that we're announcing our plan to distribute 150 million Abbott rapid point-of-care tests in the coming weeks, very, very soon. This will be more than double the number of tests already performed. And here is our plan. 50 million tests will go to protect the most vulnerable communities, which we've always promised to do, including 18 million for nursing homes, 15 million for assisted living facilities, 10 million for home health and hospice care agencies, and nearly 1 million for historically black colleges and universities and also tribal nation colleges. 100 million rapid point-of-care tests will be given to states and territories to support efforts to reopen their economies and schools immediately and fast as they can. For example, the support my administration is providing would allow every state to, on a very regular basis, test every teacher who needs it. This continues our critical effort to use testing to protect high-risk communities. These new Abbott rapid point-of-care tests are easy to use and return results within just minutes. You'll have a result at a maximum 15 minutes. No machine is required to process them. So in the old days when we just started this, you remember we'd go out and we'd have to find these massive laboratories with tremendously expensive equipment. Now we're down to something that you'll see that is really from a different planet. I would like to ask Admiral Jouar to come up and demonstrate how these tests are performed. He'll do this very nicely, I think. Good luck. Hope you don't test positive.
So thank you, Mr. President. As of today, the nation has performed over 111 million tests for the virus causing COVID. On 13 separate days, we have achieved tests over 1 million per day, and our average test numbers are now approximately 920,000 per day. We are now at an inflection point in testing. We now have available on average 3 million tests per day, not counting pooled testing, which could multiply that number several fold. Nearly half of our current tests are rapid point of care. All of the actions of your administration, including aggressive use of multiple titles of the DPA, hundreds of millions of dollars in HHS and DOD investments, and regulatory flexibility, including over 200 FDA emergency use authorizations, CLIA enforcement discretion, and application of the PREP Act, have led us to this inflection point, which brings us why we're here today. On August 27th, after months of planning and only after one day after the FDA authorization, the Trump administration awarded a contract for $760 million to Abbott for the delivery of 150 million of these Abbott BinaxNOW rapid tests. The BinaxNOW detects the presence of the COVID antigen. It uses a specific nasal swab, and that swab comes with the test, and it's made by Puritan. And the reason why Puritan swabs are here is because the administration used the DPA and $120 million in investment to make these swabs able to use by Abbott. It does not require an instrument to determine the result.
It's in 15 minutes, the result. Testing may be performed by laboratories with a clear certificate of waiver. This is not a home test. But during the health emergency, Seema Verma and CMS permits laboratories to extend their certificate to operate in temporary sites like schools or churches or parking lots. So though we anticipate that the test will generally be performed by a trained individual on a patient, I will demonstrate a self-swab for you to show you just exactly how easy the test is performed. So literally, it almost could not be easier. It starts with 6 drops of liquid onto this piece of paper. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then there's a nasal swab. And again, this is not the deep brain biopsy that we talk about. This will generally done by a healthcare provider, but it can be done supervised. It's this easy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Into the test. Twisted 3 times, the adhesive is pulled off, and you wait 15 minutes, and that is the test. It really could not be easier than this. This is a very sophisticated little piece of cardboard with lots of antibodies and incredible technology into that. We've already shipped 65,000 of these to disaster operations in California, Oregon, Texas, and Louisiana, and we have already shipped 2.1 million tests to 7,600 nursing homes, over 900,000 tests to assisted living, 300,000 tests to the Indian Health Service, and 339,000 tests to historically black colleges and university. Today, we start the shipment of 100 million tests to governors, beginning with a total of 6.5 million tests this week, to be shipped this week. This is in addition to the continuing support to other priorities like nursing homes. Allocation to states and territories is based strictly on their relative population.